That's the old John Hardy. So I'm very pleased to have my wife and daughter here. My daughter's 10 and a half, 10 and three quarters, I guess, now. But a lot of these songs I've written in those 10 years are sort of, I view as almost like a letter to her. And this next one is no different. It's called Low Hanging Fruit. And it's about how you have to decide not to necessarily pick the low-hanging fruit and pick the harder path, because sometimes that's the way to fulfillment. You don't pick the low-hanging fruit, leave it for those in need. You just set your sights on the heights that you can reach. People may say that it's good enough, but you don't have to believe, cause it might be what you're looking for beyond what they can see. You can take the easy way, tried and true, or you can make your own hay and set your own roots. When you find yourself complacent, sometimes you gotta shake the tree, cause that low-hanging fruit, saccharine bittersweet, it's bittersweet, saccharine bittersweet. Sometimes you gotta be patient, and grow some up. If you're doing something worth doing, it shouldn't come with ease. And when you're through, there'll be plenty for everyone to read. You can take the easy way, tried and true. You can make your own hay and set your own roots. When you find yourself complacent, sometimes you gotta shake the tree, cause that low-hanging fruit is sacred and bittersweet. Bittersweet, saccharine bittersweet. It's bittersweet, saccharine bittersweet. Joy to bring him here with
to share this night with you all. Yeah, Mulligan and McKelvey. It's right. That's a nice segue, Ron. Thank you. We're going to do this next song called St. Patrick's Day. And with a name like Daniel Nolan Patrick McKelvey, you're bound and determined to write one song. That's an Irish song. This is the one for me. It did take me a while, man. Thank you.
You really fulfilled the requirement, though.
So this one's St. Patrick's Day.
We're all alive.